Hard to imagine ever having to try and save school children from a shooter.
One school shooting is enough for any law enforcement officer's career. You've had three.
I've had three.
For Deputy Chief DeAndrea, the violence at Columbine was just the beginning. 7 years later, he's on the SWAT team that confronts the gunman who killed 16-year-old student Emily Keyes at Platte Canyon High School near Bailey. He's just feet away from her when she dies.
Well, I don't know if you can see, but I got a picture of Emily right here on my wall. Reminds me every day about what this job is, the ramifications of this job, and what our obligation is back to this community. Every day when I walk in here, I see that. I still wear this bracelet.
What's it say?
It says, I love you guys. 9/27/2006, Emily Keyes.
Those words are the final text message Emily sends to her dad before she dies. Almost a year later, it happens again. The Youth with a Mission missionary school shooting in Arvada. He's the fourth officer inside the building where they find four gunshot victims, including Philip Krause and Tiffany Johnson.
There on the ground was Tiffany. And she was unconscious, but she was breathing. She'd been shot 11 times.
He helps carry them both out of the building before they die at the hospital. But they had every victim out of this building within 10 minutes of the first 911 call. Proof of the skills they learned after Columbine, like quick responses, no longer waiting for SWAT officers, but teaching patrolmen how to get inside a school right away if there's a gunman. And from the Platte Canyon shooting came something called the Standard Response Protocol, training that's now in place in 22,000 schools across the U.S. and Canada, even in preschools, colleges, businesses, getting police and educators on the same page. Using the same language, creating lockdown and lockout procedures that keep people alive.
I truly believe that lessons learned from Columbine helped save lives that day.
And even his day-to-day conversations since Columbine may have helped save at least one precious life.
You can imagine, dinner at my home was instilled to this day, right? It's a little bit different. We talk about these things. We talk about, you know, life-saving strategies. What do we do? It is incumbent upon me as a father, not just a cop, but as a father, to talk to my daughters about if this happens, what are we going to do?
So when your daughter was in a bar in Thousand Oaks, California last year?
Yeah, so.
She knew what to do?
Right.
As if three school shootings aren't enough, his daughter is inside this bar and grill back in November when a gunman walks in and kills 12 people.
I get a text from my daughter that says, I love you guys.
Just like Emily Keyes.
Just like Emily Keyes.
You can imagine the panic going through this father's mind. But because of all those post-Columbine conversations.
She knew exactly what to do. So she looks around the kitchen, and she actually saw a lady climbing into the attic. There was a ladder on the wall. She sees this gal going up there, and so she climbs up there, and some more people followed her.
After an hour and a half, SWAT team members rescue her and the others barricaded inside. Just as A.J. DeAndrea did at the Columbine shooting 20 years earlier, his first of too many such rescues.
You've been through three school shootings. In the back of your head, do you fear there will be a fourth?
I believe that there will be a fourth.
Yeah, his goal is to get everybody on his department prepared if that does happen. Our coverage continues tomorrow night at 5 when we talk to the family of teacher Dave Sanders. Why strangers come up to them even 20 years later and thank them for their dad's heroics inside Columbine that day. And a programming reminder, hope you join us this Saturday for a Fox 31 news special, Columbine 20, Heartbreak to Hope. We have spent weeks and traveled thousands of miles gathering the stories of Columbine victims and survivors, and we'll present them commercial free at 5:30 and 9:30 p.m. Saturday right here on Fox 31.
Now, Columbine.